Hello folks, welcome back to the Pedersoli Whitworth Rifle Observations and Modifications Part 3. In the previous video we talked about fitting two risers on the front sight in conjunction with the Lyman 22 sight. Now, sorry to mislead you, I've been calling it a 22 sight, and in actual fact it's mostly used on 22s or 22s depending on which part of the world you come from. Yeah, but its proper designation is the Lyman 20MJ, but not to worry. I'm happy to say that we are on paper now. We are hitting the ball with the combination of the very tall front sight and the Pedersoli Generation 2 rear sight. Not quite all the way down. I'll show you the settings that we were able to hit paper with. Can you see that? It's not very good. Trying to get some light there. So we're not quite at the bottom. Where are we? We are slightly above the quarter mark, so slightly above 0.25. Try and get that in there. Can you see? Quite sure. So anyway, we've got a bit of leeway, a tiny little way we can go lower than that, but we've also got all the adjustment above, so it is possible. I just want to outline the one thing I don't like about this sight is this. In order to release the staff so that I can lay it down, I have to use an Allen key to undo this grub screw. And then it will move, but also, which is not really a fault of this, it's the same with most sights, you have to release this screw and then crank the eyepiece up out of the way, and then it will fold down further. The Red River sight doesn't suffer from that because it has a detent spring in the bottom, which allows the sight staff to fold forwards and backwards. That's a really good feature of that. And there's also lots of other good features about the Red River sight that I like. Mostly the pochard type adjustment, where the adjustment screw is right in the middle here, and these are threaded internally. So which is great, because you don't have a knob sticking up the top, you don't have another threaded piece to collect dirt and muck, and there's no backlash with this system. Well, there is a tiny bit of backlash with this, and some sites you get a lot of backlash. So anyway, we have got it hitting paper at 100 yards. I'll show you the target. I was going to do, well, I did a video outside on the day, but the weather turned really bad. Turned to heavy wind and rain, and I lost the light. So, you can see from the crumpled state of the target that it got soaked, and I had to roll it up and bring it back and dry it out. But anyway, there we are. 2 in the 10 and 1 in the 9. So we're not doing too bad, and really not looking for a huge amount of accuracy there. We're just trying to get in the ballpark. So we're using the Cal Tool and Die bullet mold to make a hexagonal bullet, paper wrapped or paper patched, depending on how you want to look at it, sitting on top of 70 grains of GOX3F, and I was only using an over powder card. I wasn't using any other type of wad. So we're just using a very thin hexagonal over powder card. This was supplied by Cal Tool and Die, and it's a grease cookie. It's a hexagonal grease cookie, which is felt soaked in lubricant. I don't know what lubricant he uses. As soon as I get some Suitable felt. I'm going to be using my own lubricant, which is beeswax and tallow, 50-50 mixture with a smidgen of neatsville oil. It seems to work very well on in other applications, so I'm going to try making grease cookies with that. So yeah, there we are. Reasonably successful afternoon yesterday. So we're not far off. We are able to hit the target with a sight, and that foresight we have. We may be able to put this Red River back on, I'm not sure. Let's just look at the height there. Perhaps not, I don't know. I don't know, we might give it a go. It's not far off. We might give it a go, see what we can do, and then make our minds up what we're going to do about a rear sight for this gun, because this is going to come off and go back on the shaft. Another little gadget we've got here is a hexagonal wad cutter. And this comes from Peter Dyson in England. Handy little gadget. I'd thought of making my own, but then I thought, well, how on earth do you do that? And it's just easy to buy one. You notice the inside is hexagonal. And then you can grind and sharpen the outside to keep it sharp. And the size will always stay the same. I haven't ground this one, this is the way that it came. Looks like it's made out of stainless with a fork welded on the top. And the bottom piece looks cast. Not really sure, but if you want to make hexagonal wads, you're going to need this. So a little shout out for Peter Dyson there. Also a shout out for Cal Tool and Die for their excellent bullet mold and their bits and pieces. So there we are, another look at the target. We're not doing too bad. Again, we're not chasing accuracy here, we're just trying to get in the ballpark. We're going to look at other things now. Different powder charges, different alloy for the bullet, probably because this was almost pure lead as far as I can tell. Came from some scrap lead that I was given. And judging by the bullet weights from my Lyman bullet mold, they came out exactly right. So it should be pure lead, but I'm not sure. But Cal Tool and I give you a bullet weight for an alloy of lead. I can't quite remember what it is, but anyway. My bullets come out heavier than their quoted weight. So I'm looking at pure lead. Okay, better stop waffling. So we've achieved some success with that horrendous looking front sight. Looks like a pile of sandwiches with a sight stuck on the top. So yeah, Pedersoli Whitworth rifle, rear sight is a Pedersoli Goodwin Generation 2, front sight is a Lyman 20mm with two Pedersoli sight risers. Okay, there you go, have fun shooting, take care of yourselves, look after one another, talk to you next time, goodbye.